get comfortable. Say if you guys comfortable. All right. I'm feeling good right now. How y'all feeling?
Good.
All right. So, who's my target customer? Right? Who I need to focus on? What's my target clientele? What's my target customer service? What this narrows my focus. Which category does your business exist? Right? Don't generalize it. Right? But she's focused. And that's a strategy. We know singers who are all over the place. I can do crossover, I can do pop, I can do this. And that's great, but when you're starting out, focus. What's your benefit? Right? What is that one thing that makes your service great? Your business great? What is it? We lose sight of that because we're trying to do so much. We're on social media and we're blogging and we want to write a book and we want to start this and we want to do that. And we're doing so many things that we're not really maximizing what makes us great. Right? Is it the talent? Is it your intellect, your imagination? Could you understand if you focus right there, that would put you to a whole other level. Promise you. As I close, McDonald's. Some of you heard of this story. McDonald's started their business in San Bernardino, California. Mom and pop business. Right? Two brothers, same philosophy as mine. We're gonna eat what we kill, we're gonna serve barbecue, briskets, hot tamales, burgers. We got it all. Come on. We got it all, right? The family. They focused on the family. And then they started realizing, look, what category does your business exist? Oh, well, we're a restaurant. We sell food. Well, we're a restaurant. No. What category? Well, barbecue. No, focus. What's your focus? We got briskets. We got hot tamales. That's not focus. What is your focus? We got it. Burgers, drinks, and fries. Burgers, drinks, and fries. That's the focus. What makes you unique, Mr. McDonald? What is it about your burgers, your drinks, and your fries that make you unique? Were they good? No, that's not enough. The next person got good burgers. I got it. We can make our burgers, drinks, and fries faster than anyone else. And they formed an assembly line type structure on making it fast. Back in the day, it was normal to get a burger and wait about 30 minutes. And at McDonald's, they were making burgers in less than a moment. That was their unique benefit. And so McDonald's was growing, and it went into a franchise, and it was popping up all across the nation. McDonald's here, McDonald's there, McDonald's everywhere, right? And then you know how it is when you grow your business, right? Other people want to compete with you. Other people mimic what you do. So other burger shops were doing the same thing. And you know what? These burger shops said, you know what? They got good, fast burgers, but we're going to make bigger burgers. And they started making bigger burgers. And now McDonald's was like, here are my competitors. How do I distinguish myself from the competitor? Right? What do I need to do? There's bigger burgers. And so they started thinking to themselves. And they said, we got it. We got something that's real nice, double decker. Right? Two slices of real beef. Special sauce, right? We sesame seed bun, we got it. The cost of living in different countries, wow, big man. now, when you go to McDonald's, you can find oatmeal, you can find parfaits, toilets, right? Ice waffles, fruit, all of that. Why? Because initially, they narrowed their what? Their focus. My question for you, ladies and gentlemen, what is your Big Mac? Thank you.